Hey everybody, it's Todd Bartusik with Berkshire Hathaway Real Estate and the All Metro Real Estate Group. So I'm coming to you again with the September market stats for Westside Homes. So what we saw in September compared to August was we saw a drop of homes sold of about 29%. So we went from 28 units down to 20 units. Doesn't surprise me. I mean, that's what kind of happens when we get into the fall. It just kind of slows down a little bit. But what we're seeing though is we're seeing that prices have not taken a back seat. So we went from 371 and some small change in August to a 379.5 basically in September, and that was an increase of about 2.2%. You know, so that's a positive overall stat for anybody that owns a home in the district, or even if you're a buyer, because what it tells us is that prices are still moving. So that's the overall market in Westside. Then I like to talk about the first-time homebuyer price point. That's zero to 350,000. Now we saw another drop there. We went from 19 units to 12 units, which is a drop of about 37%. Average price in the starter price point was up about 2.3%. So about 248 to about 254. So again, that's really consistent with the overall market. Our days on market went from 6 to 11. So that, you know, that's not that big of a deal. I mean, that's still a low days on market. You know, really what I'm seeing, you guys, is the market is sort of normalizing from what it was maybe a few years ago, kind of like pre-COVID. Now prices are still way up compared to what pre-COVID was, but we're just not seeing tons of multiple offers. But what we have in the district is we have an inventory challenge. Right, so that's why, I mean, if a house gets listed and it's in good condition and it's priced reasonably, it's gonna probably sell about in that first week or so. So things to really pay attention, you know, you've gotta make sure that the house is, you know, dialed in, manicured lawn, you know, the shrubs and the bushes look good, landscaping, mulch, right to the inside where, you know, everything's, you know, just is detailed. Like if you're selling a car, right, you're going to detail your car, same thing you do, you do the detail of the house, but it's just on a bigger, broader scale. So back to the move up, the 350 to 750. So we saw a decrease actually in price from about 451 down to about 442. The reason I think that is because that's kind of a challenging price in the district. And what we see at times, if you have a house that's in that price point, 450-ish, there are a lot of times it's gonna need some updates. Well, our buyer pool has sort of changed a bit over the last couple of years, I would say, where, you know, the buyer is just expecting more. They don't really wanna do anything. So that buyer that comes in and sees, you know, dated carpet or dated appliances or Formica countertops or whatever, they're looking at that saying, well, we don't want that, so we're willing to wait for the house that gets listed that has those features to check those boxes off. So again, those are things to be thinking about if you're a possible seller, or if you know someone that's thinking about selling. There's really kind of a checklist that I internally go through myself when I meet with a seller, and I talk about these things. Sometimes they do it, sometimes they don't, but I always want to talk about things that are going to have an impact on the return on investment, the ROI, right? So that was the move up. Again, we dropped about 10,000 overall for that move up price point. Then the last one that I always talk about is the luxury, that's 750 and above. So in August we had two, September we had two, and we had an average price point go from about 1.2 million to about 903,000. So that was a drop of about 26%. Now, if you're a luxury seller or even a luxury buyer, don't freak out and thinking that your house is either plummeting or you can go out and get a steal, because we just had some lower priced, higher end houses that were sold in the month of September. So again, overall guys, the market is still solid. It's still strong, just not what it was a couple years ago. Interest rates have dropped about 1 point in the last month or so, and so that helps the overall market, and really it helps consumer confidence. So if you have any questions about the market, or if you're possibly thinking about maybe selling your house in the next, you know, 3, 6, 12 months and want to get started on the things that you actually should do to you know, that way you can hit the, you know, hit the ball out of the park, so to speak, you know, when you do list, give me a call, put my almost 25 years to work for you. And I would love to help, and there's no obligation. So if you like the information that I provide here, please remember to follow me on social media and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.